What's up, guys and gals? Welcome back to the Nerdcastle. Today in the world of indie games, we're going to be taking a look at a title called Spellmasons. This is a game that has a very, very solid sense of identity. Like, this is a game that knows what it wants to be, but if I had to describe it to anybody, this is basically a permadeath, chaos-conjuring, warlock roguelike. This is a game where you take one character with one life and you take random spells that you get. The game has sort of like a sequential programming language to it, almost. Don't flinch at the sound of that. You'll see what I mean once we play the game. But basically, you get to make all your spells from scratch using a bunch of modifiers that are sequentially applied on the spell. And so, for example, if you had like a lightning strike that hits one guy from above, you could add a cone modifier to it. Now it'll hit everything in a cone. But that's not all you could do. You could make it so that the lightning chains another cone to another group of enemies from the final person that you target by putting another cone spell on it, and then you could put a bleed spell on it so that in the second cone, the guys that move have to bleed as they get towards you until they die. Very, very interesting idea for a game that's all about kind of like being thoughtful and figuring out good combinations that'll wipe out huge packs of enemies. This is not a game about, you know, this is not a game about sterile wizards casting magic missiles that go pew and hit you in the chest and then you fall over. This is about tearing your enemies asunder with arcane magic, and you'll see what I mean in just a second. So we're going to dive on in today for about 30 minutes and see if it's something you wanted to add to your wish list or otherwise pass on. If after watching this you wanted to add the game to your wish list, I got a link for you down below in the description where you can get ready for the 31st and check it out there. On top of that, you'll also find a link to my Discord, my Twitch stream, and all my other related social media stuff, because I am back now after the hack, just in case you missed the last video. Let's go ahead and start a run. It's a really simple game. You guys are going to catch on very, very quickly, I promise. So at the beginning of the game, we get to draft a couple of spells. We can get a repel that knocks enemies back from the center of the circle. It's basically an AoE that shoves them away from the point of casting. We've got heal, that'll allow us to heal ourselves. We've also got bloat, which is a modifier that you can curse the enemy with that makes them explode, dealing 4 damage and knocking enemies back all around them. It's really, really good. I like bloat a lot. I'm going to take heal, though, because I've never taken it before. And so I'll take heal real fast. We can get a rend spell, or we can get a pull spell, or a freeze spell. I'm going to go with rend, because that allows me to modify my attack to make it hit harder. And so anyways, we'll go and we'll put the heal spell over there. We'll put rend right there. This is all interactable, and you can arrange your hotbar however you'd like to do so. At the beginning of every single contest of wills, I don't call them levels, I call them contests of will, we get to decide where we want to deploy. I'm going to deploy right here in the middle of all these enemies, and I'm just going to cast a quick slash on that guy to kill him off. So there you go. He's been annihilated by my slash spell. This guy right here, we're probably going to want to stack some slashes to get rid of him, so I stack 2 slashes right there, and he's now dead. At the bottom of the screen, you can see a couple of different meters. We've got our health, we've got our stamina, and we've got our mana. Our health, when that goes down to 0, we die and we start over from the beginning, doing it all over again. The stamina is what we use to move around the map. You can hold down the F key to see how far, basically, you can move on one thing of stamina, and also what your range will be once you get there. The game's got lots of rulers, it's got lots of things that allow you to figure stuff out, because it is a contemplative game, but that guy dropped a spell and I want it. So I think I'm going to take bloat right here so that I can convert my enemies into bombs and make them explode. I'm going to end my turn. Oh, that guy could actually hit me from that range. All right. Surprised me. I didn't think he would be able to. Okay, we can slash him. But what I'd like to do is I just want to heal myself. So there we go. All nice and healed up. I've got enough mana left to where I think I can do like a supercharged slash by using rend. What rend does is it adds damage to any attack you link it to, and the specific amounts of damage are listed on the card that you're seeing on screen right now on the tooltip. We'll go ahead and cast that, and it's not going to kill him, but it is going to hurt. Like, he's definitely going to think about his life decisions after he soaks that one. We don't have to worry about maintaining our health in between levels. We do heal back up to full when we go to the next level. So it's no biggie if we end this level at like 1 HP. Let's just go ahead and drop another one on him. And there it is. He's all nice and dead. And then we go to the portal and we go to level 2. We get a bonus. Every single time we go to a new level, you get a perk. Perks are distinct from your casting spells. So perks are going to do things like give you more stamina, give you more health, give you more mana. There's right here, overflowing mana gives you a 20% chance at the beginning of every turn to get double mana for that turn. And that's really, really strong. So I think I'm going to take it. Having double mana allows you to just do absolutely apocalyptic things to the enemy. This is a pretty segmented map, and I feel like we're safe. So I'm just going to drop in right here, and I'm going to waste these two zombies. Ooh, there's a spell. Okay, I'll get the free spell. I do think it's a good idea that we either get some kind of AoE targeting or we get some kind of movement spell pretty soon. I'm going to take freeze for now because freeze is a stun. It lets me force the enemy to skip a turn, basically. I'm going to set up behind this trap, and the trap should do my business for me, I was going to say. And then we'll finish that guy off right there. Good stuff. I could have also pushed those guys into a trap. I could have pulled the trap to them. I could have done a bunch of stuff if I had had more things to play around with, but let's go ahead and I will take some more health because we are squishy right now. We are very, very squishy. So what am I looking at? I got two slimes down there. I got a bunch of zombies up there. Okay, let's deal with the slimes first. I don't know how big the bloat AoE is. It's kind of hard to say from where I'm sitting right now. Let me take a spell off right here. I don't want to blow myself up with my own spell effect is what I'm worried about. You can absolutely do that, and it is bad when it happens to you. Let's just kill him off for right now. We've got the benefit of a healing spell, and there's healing potions like everywhere, so we may be able to do something here. With 15 mana left, there's not a whole lot of plays that I can make, so we'll just wait right here. We'll take our damage on the chin, and then we'll decide how we want to deal with all these guys. I will probably go for another triple rend right there. Well, I don't actually need the triple rend, do I? Oh, I do need the triple rend. Okay, we'll do the triple rend right there, and we'll take that guy out. Perfect. He's got a magic spell. We'll want to pick that up sooner rather than later. I'm going to move all the way down to this corner, though, because I'm a little bit worried he can get to me. I was correct. He absolutely can get to me. All right, so let's give him a slash. Let's give ourselves a heal. Let's give him a slash. I'm going to go get this spell right here. We got bleed. Deals more damage based on how much health the target is missing. A target with 30% health will die. 40% health, 25% of max health is damage. 65% health. Okay, so basically that's like a finisher spell right there. We use that to kill people. Gotcha. We also have drown, which can be kind of nice, but I don't have a way to push or pull people into water. So I don't know if that's going to be super helpful. We'll go with bleed for right now. And I am curious about how that's going to work for me. But I don't think it's going to matter because I think we just finished the level. All right, so level 4, we got a lava pit. I'm going to start boosting my mana since that lets me do more stuff on a turn. And I think what I'd like to do is I'd like to be right here. And I'd like to do a bloat into a slash. Perfect. That actually went exactly how I saw it in my head. And then that guy right there, we'll finish him off. We are going to have to deal with that archer in a minute because he can basically ping us from anywhere on the map. Captures the soul. You can summon them at will. Ooh, nice, dude. I'm down for some soul stealing. The good news is archers don't deal hardly any damage. So we should be able to just, like, heal it off as necessary. Let's try this capture soul thing. Oh, but the capture soul doesn't, like, kill him or anything. It just gives us... Oh! And it's very, very pricey as well, but it looks like we can do it 7 times. Okay. I'm gonna eat that hit right there. Ooh, he got a hit off, too. That's no bueno. All right, let's go ahead and kill him off real fast. We will go for a heal. I don't know if I want to do a second heal. We got a health potion right here. So I can pick that up on the next turn. And if I can get around this trap, I think we might be able to do something here. Can I attack the trap? I cannot. Okay. That's fine. See, that's what I wanted to avoid right there. That's what I was trying to avoid. I didn't know if I could sneak around the edge right there. So I wanted to see if I could kill the trap or not. We'll go ahead and just rend this guy real quick. Boom. There it is. We're out of here. Let's go to the next level. We've got a easy blight kill right there. I'll probably take mana right here. We haven't got that 20% proc yet. My heart is broken. Let's go for a bloat into a slash right there. Perfecto. Could not have gone better. We'll go for a rend, a double rend right here. We've got one more archer over there. We can slow an enemy by lowering their max stamina. Let's get connect going on, because connect allows us to basically turn any spell into chain lightning. Dash might also be helpful as well. Basically, we want to start looking at either AoEs or movement spells. Let's try out dash for the moment. That guy can't see me. That's the stipulation with archers, is they don't fire their weapon if they can't see you. I don't know if I can get to that right there. I can. Okay. Then let's rend that boy up right there. Grab the mana pot. I could dash to him. And then finish him off right there. Yeah, there you go. Bleed the blood of failure. All right, zombie. What you got to show me? What you got going on, zombie? You got anything worrisome? You got anything crazy? Here, enjoy. I gave you a hyper-powered slash, even though I didn't need it, because I have a respect for decorum. All right, so now we're starting to get into the big enemies. I will take another 10 mana. Why not? My question is, so these are stronger versions down here? But I do have the ability to detonate a blight right there and maybe do something. This may get me killed, but I'm going to start off aggressive because I believe in aggressive openings. All right. We'll go for a bloat. Maybe. Oh, no, I misclicked. Oh, God. Okay. Yep, that's going to mess things up. Yeah, those guys have more HP than I expected. All right. All right. All right. Let's do a bloat into a slash. I mean, it killed some of them. Probably could have been better, but, you know. We're going to want to freeze this guy right here so that we can deal with him. I want my spell to target in a circle. There we go. That's the good stuff. All right. Let's wait it out for a minute. I don't have any pushes or anything. Otherwise, I'd push him into the lava. Spoiler alert, he's not going to die when you push him into the lava, but he is going to hurt really, really badly. He's not going to enjoy it. Let's go for another freeze on this guy just to keep him locked down, because I got a feeling he hits like a truck. Yeah, he hits for 5 damage. So you can click on any enemy on the map. That was a more challenging sentence than I thought it was going to be. So I tried to fire it off from the hip, you know what I mean? Like gunslinger style. And my tongue was just like, nah, man, that's not how that works. That's not how that works. All right, let's see if we can get this guy at least click-clacked up a little bit. Perfect. He's down. We're going to want to... Got a big zombie over there. I don't know what I want to do about him. Ever so slightly out of range. Big zombie, what do I want to do about you? I'm just going to try to get a gap because I don't know how far he can move. He can move pretty good. He's spry for a big guy. They have enough DPS to kill me, like in one turn, but we got double mana right here. So let's do a circle target. And the circle target will go into a... Technically, I could do the summon, actually. We have the mana for it. Cool. Probably didn't do much for me, but it looked awesome. I mean, it forced him to waste a turn. What else can you ask for? We're inside a range right here. That's what the little swords mean above their head, is that we can hit them from right here. Let's go for a chained, or we'll go for a circle slash into the biggest rend that we can drop. Okay, that worked out all right. I'm going to corner up. He may still get to hit me. He didn't get to hit me. And then we might get to use our bleed spell right here. Hey, there it is, just to finish him off nice and cheap. All right, next setup. We've got a new enemy type in here. I'm going to go for 100, man. I'm going all in on the turn economy. I forget what this guy does right here. This guy right here infects you and gives you, like, poison. This guy, I don't recall what he does. He does something, trademark. This might be a mistake, but I'm going to do it. What does he do? Oh, he's a poisoner. All right. So what does this guy do then? He's a vampire. Gotcha. So if he bites me, I get infected with Blood Curse. Blood Curse doubles my HP, but it means that anytime I use a healing effect on myself, I get wounded instead. So, like, basically, getting the Blood Curse can be kind of good depending if you're using blood magic or not. So anything that drains your HP in order to cast blood magic, or I'm sorry, the Blood Curse is going to go pretty well with that. But otherwise, 24 HP on that lad. Good lord. All right. We may have to do some freezing here. Yeah, let's open with a freeze on the big dog. He's like a big, gloopy mass of toothpaste, so like freezing should work well. We will go for a... You have 6 HP. Nice. Get a little bit of extra damage right there. We want to stay out of the line of sight of all these guys if we can manage it. I'm going to end my turn right there. That guy's going to close with me. Oh, we actually have, like, issues here. Okay. How much HP do you have? 14. Doesn't matter, in my opinion. Because I think what I'm going to do is we'll go bloat into a slash right there. I was hoping it would get the archer too, but it didn't. Scooch forward a little bit. It knocked him aside. And then potentially... So I can't dash just to like a location? Oh, I can dash to a corpse though. Okay. I want to finish him off by the end of the turn, but I don't know exactly how I want to accomplish that. We'll dash to him. Grab this spell. So we've got Purify, removes all curses. We've got Pull. I would have rather had Push. Makes the target take double damage whenever they receive damage stackable. Yeah, I'll take that. So this guy right here. We need him to go, but he's got... No, he doesn't have bloat on him. Okay, good. No bloat on him. So he's got what? 10 HP left? All right. We'll go for a big hit right there just to get him off the board since he represents like a long-term threat to the run. I do wish that I could dash to a location, but I think we're going to get smote on this turn. Ow. Okay. Yep. I was right about that. We got hit really, really, really hard. All these archers are going to have to go too. Can I dash to this archer? Not quite. What about now? Okay, so I can dash to that archer. I can get into cover. I need a heal spell on me just to stay alive for another turn. We're going to triple target rend that guy. I don't think I can make it to the stamina potion in time. But I tried. We got a huge amount of mana here, so let's go ahead. Our proc went off. Let's go ahead and do some summoning. We'll get a zombie down. We'll put debilitate, and we're just going to go for one big Kraken hit on this dude. Love the little levitation right there. Was he doing that every time I cast that? I feel like the more powerful and the more... I think what they have going on is that the spell has a technical level and it increases by one every time you add a new mod. And I think the casting animation changes based on basically what level the spell is that you're honking off at the enemy. And so anyways, some cool stuff in there. No mana potions or anything around. Okay, they're going to spend their turn killing my zombie. But I did get some stamina back right here. We'll go for a circle mod. Actually, I don't know if the circle mod is the best thing to do here. I think instead what we could do is I think a bloat would solve the issue the exact same way, but I got to get out of range of my bloat. There we go. All right, let me grab that potion right there. We've got a level 2 archer over on this side. And with all the extra stamina that I stacked up, I was able to get over here. There we go. Down goes the enemy. Next map. What do we got going on? The Ghost Archer. Their arrows pierce units, dealing half damage to them on the way to the target. It'll target the farthest enemy. Okay. Fair enough. And a green glop. It attacks up to 6 enemies. It lobs gloop high up in the air to damage its enemies. Okay. Let's take... another bit of health here because we're starting to get hit pretty hard. And looking at the lay of the land, there's a priest over here. The priest resurrects enemies when they die. So I do think he's going to have to be dealt with, but like, it's like, where do I deploy here? Because I've got a lot of ranged enemies around. I'll probably go like right here so that I've got line of sight from the gloop. I've got line of sight from the big dog. We're still getting hit from a couple of different angles, but I'm going to try to solve that right now. So we can get a kill off right there just for a nice, quick, cheap cast. And so the priest is now dead. I'm going to need another rend right there to get him. I have just the tiniest bit of mana remaining, but I need to kind of corner up so that these guys can't get to me in one turn. And then on this side, I can't kill him just yet, but I can get him started so that we can bleed him on the next turn. Okay, so we need a bloat into a slash right there. Let me just scooch a little bit to make sure I don't get hit. There we go. They've been knocked back. We'll go for a slash right there. I don't have a lot of mana remaining. He's got 6 HP. Oof, I don't know what my choices are here. Tough one. I don't have the mana to do what I want to do. I can dash to that. I now have push. Although, what I would like to see here is either a second hotbar that shows up when you hold down control or like shift. That way you can get to your abilities a little bit better. We need to stay away from all this stuff that is happening down up here with the melees and whatnot. I'm a little bit worried about dashing into the blood right there. I'll give it a try, though. Okay, a little bit of damage taken, but it could have been worse. And I think we have a setup right here, but I'm pretty beat. We'll go for... Yeah, do it. I'm kind of in a spot where I need stuff to die, and I need it to die, like, right now. I'm gonna try to reserve enough to heal myself. Oh, but that archer over there is gonna get me. Oh, boy. Okay. Let's think about this. Let's take push. Debilitate makes me deal double damage. Might be an option. Nah, it's still not going to get us there. Bleed actually messes that guy up pretty good and leaves us enough for a heal. Thank you, Bleed. You just bailed me out of a tight situation. I'm going to get some health back. I'm out of stamina, so this may be the turn. Oh, the archer over there didn't fire at me. Good. Okay, give me another heal. I think we go for like a double rend right there. Actually, I think bleed has been more efficient this entire time. Kind of. Yeah, that works out for me. I'll take it. I'm not upset with that result. Finish him off as well. And then we got to deal with that final archer. I am taking poison damage, though, so we're going to have to like sort that out at some point, too. I'm going to move forward, and can I dash to... I wanted to dash... Oh, I can dash to that one, though. There we go. And then I can dash to that one right there. I can't dash to him just yet, but, you know, we put up a solid effort. I can't push myself, unfortunately. I think we'll just wait it out. Ow, that hurts so much. Okay, all right, you're the man. I'm gonna go ahead and heal that real fast because that was stingy. What's your attack power? 6 attack power. Oh, wow. So he's hitting us for like the vast majority of our HP. Gotcha. If I could get over to a spot where I want to be, what we could potentially do. Oh, the blood doesn't hurt him. Okay, never mind then. We could go for a bleed hit right there. Perfect. Absolutely fantastic. What do we have going on in this level? Oh, the levels are getting big, man. They're getting chunky. I'll probably take more mana. I find that like having turn economy makes me feel good about myself. All right, so you, if I can drop you with just like a quick rend, that's fine. And then we come down here with this guy. You push him through the trap. Well, that's an annoyance. All right, so we've got shove, we've got radius. Okay, so that just boosts the radius on the circle that we already have. Gotcha. Purify might be a nice thing to have in our back pocket just in case things get a little bit crazy. I don't think I have dash range right now. Yeah, I don't. Oh, and the Rezzer, he's going to keep falling back. That's not great. That's actually kind of bad. We do have a play here, though. It's not a great play, but it is a play. I could go debilitate first into a actually. Let me see what I can do here. Yeah, I think we put like a debilitate on the front end of that maybe. So that everybody takes double damage from the Explodomancy. It gets us closer, but I think we're still dead here. Unless I do something. Did all right. It did okay. I need to get the Rezzer dead is what I need. I'll kind of like dash back over to here. But I don't feel like I have too many more plays. Yeah, just like a little baby slash right there, but okay, so what did I... Was that a vampire right there? Oh, I think we just got... Did we get blood cursed? I did not get blood cursed. We did luck out and get a huge mana turn, though. Oh, but I think they... Do they all have bloat on them? Is that what's going wrong right there? Hold on a second. Let me... Before an accident happens. Ah, they all have bloat on them. Okay, so I'm going to need to, like, dash over to here. And then I'm going to have to kind of go wide. Woo! Okay, there's some chaos right there. And that's where the fun, I think, starts to come in with this game. Is once you start realizing, like, there are combos that will make it happen, Cap'n. Like, there are some combos in this game that are straight up filthy. Like, they annihilate the enemy. And then that combined... Hopefully he doesn't have bloat on him. If he has bloat on him, this is going to be bad for me. Can't dash to you, even though I want to. I guess just cast another heal, I suppose. Ow. Okay. Do not know at all how I want to deal with these archers, and that guy's falling back like crazy. Okay, let's kill you off first so that I don't have anybody trying to chase me down at the moment. I need to get inside dash range, but I just don't know if I'm going to be able to do it. I have a push spell. So if I go up to here and I push you to there, I can dash to you. We may be dead right here. Yeah, we're dead right here. Ah, we made it so far. We tried our best. The map was not fortuitous. But anyways, this is Spellmasons. I think it's a really, really cool game. I think this game is going to live or die based on the amount of combos that there are to play. Like, as of right now, I haven't seen any lightning spells. I haven't seen any fireballs or anything, or like flames or anything of that nature. It seems like most of it is just like warlock nastiness, like tearing the enemy apart at like a material level. But I dig it. But variety. Variety is going to be the spice of life with this one. From what I've played, I've done 4 or 5 runs, and I've seen a lot of repeats. But on this run, I saw some new stuff. So there are rare cards, and I've only seen a couple of those. So I'm guessing when the rares come up, that's where the builds start to get really, really interesting. But I highly recommend checking this game out. This game knows what it is. It doesn't apologize for it. It executes. Once you figure out like the iconography of how the game works and what all the symbols mean and everything else, the spell building process is really, really fun and reminds me of something like Magicka, for example. And so anyways, I think people are really going to like this game. I could see it developing kind of like a cult following. My name is Splattercat. I sift through the pile to find what is worthwhile in the world of indie games every single day so that you don't have to. Today up on the chopping block, we had Spellmasons. I'm a little late on the coverage. They gave it to me like a week and a half ago, but like, you know, got hacked. Sorry about that, folks, but I should be back from here on out. Check it out down below in the description, and that's about all I got for you. Take care, everybody, and I hope that your holiday was wonderful.